Two autofocus related features have evolved on EOS R series cameras in the past few years. The first are the available AF areas, or size of the active AF boxes used for autofocus. And then there's the issue of whether or not focus tracking is active with different AF areas. Before we even go any further, let's clarify a few things. If you own a first generation EOS R5 or R6 camera, you'll see that what we now call AF area was previously called AF method. The name has changed, but the concept is the same. How large an area is being sampled for autofocus. And let's be sure we're clear when we say focus tracking. On any modern mirrorless camera, focus tracking means the ability to begin focusing on a moving subject in one location in the frame. And if the subject moves or composition changes, active AF points likewise change location to continue to keep focus upon the subject. With older SLR cameras, we often use the term focus tracking to simply mean continuous servo autofocus upon a moving subject. But it was understood in those days that we meant using one stationary focus point, which the photographer kept upon that moving subject. Modern day mirrorless focus tracking frees the photographer from keeping the original fixed focus area upon that moving subject. With the EOS R1 and R5 Mark II cameras, selecting your active AF area, whether it's a single AF point or a larger area, now lets you also directly tell the camera whether to use only that AF area or whether to allow autofocus to now move the focus detection area around the frame if the subject or composition changes. AF area choices continue the trends we've seen in recent EOS cameras. Spot AF, 1-point AF, 4-point expanded AF, 8-point or around AF, 3 user-adjustable options for flexible zone AF, and whole area AF, which was formerly called Face Detect Plus Tracking on the original EOS R5 and R6 cameras. But you'll also see 4 additional AF area choices in the EOS R5 Mark II and EOS R1 cameras with a little lock icon on them. These will be important in some situations. These AF area options lock out any focus tracking and mean that the photographer alone positions the active AF area. Once he or she does, it will not change size or try to identify what it's upon and then move if composition changes or the subject itself begins to move around the frame. They also lock out any subject to detect settings. In other words, to use AF as we traditionally did with digital SLRs, as you might in something like precise landscape or macro shooting, the AF area choices with the lock icon will free you from any concerns about the focus area shifting or moving. Focus tracking with live subjects, however, can sometimes really be a liberating feature. Even in portrait shooting with a relatively stationary subject, it can allow easy, slight changes in composition while the camera continues to focus on whatever was identified as the initial subject. And this doesn't require formal people, animal, or vehicle subject detection. You can select the 1-point AF area to begin with, put it upon something like the label of a wine bottle, a flower, or a distant building, activate autofocus, and the camera will often change the size of the focus box in the viewfinder to let you know it's identified what you initially aimed it at. In servo AF, this will now continuously reposition this focus box, letting you know it's actively tracking whatever you'd initially pointed the AF area at. In other words, using AF areas without the little lock icon, you can start out using just that specific AF area, but the camera can then immediately resize the AF area as it identifies what you placed it upon and seamlessly activate whole area focus tracking to keep it in focus, even if things move. Especially if you're set for servo AF, where autofocus expects subject movement, you can temporarily toggle back and forth between letting the camera identify a subject and then use tracking to follow it if something moves, or using your initial fixed AF area and its location. Using a button to turn whole area AF tracking on and off, when your autofocus is active, we'll do this, and you'll see it in the viewfinder of the EOS R1 or R5 Mark II cameras. By default, the Set button will do this as you are actively using servo AF, but you can customize another button to start, stop, whole area AF tracking. Here's the bottom line. Canon's latest AF makes it pretty seamless to simply use a single AF point or expanded AF points and limit any focus detection to just that AF area alone. Just pick your AF area of choice with the little lock icon. Or, for the flexibility of focus tracking, select the AF area you want without the lock icon. You can temporarily halt any tracking during servo AF shooting by pressing whatever button you've set for whole area AF tracking on and off. Press it again to restore active AF tracking. Anytime there are a lot of options, it can seem challenging to fully understand. We hope, however, that this initial glance at the updated AF areas in the EOS R1 and R5 Mark II cameras and how they integrate with focus tracking will give you some clarity as you begin to look at these innovative cameras.